It's a summertime job. It really is. So we got the doorposts in yesterday. It rained all day. We couldn't even film it, so it was miserable. And it's very sticky today, trying to move around. Right, so it's been raining again. It wasn't supposed to rain this morning. It's been chucking it down, and everything's soaking wet as usual. So it's the wrong time to do this, especially when it comes to putting the polythene on. You want it mild. It is really mild at this time of year. I reckon it's gonna be 15, 16 degrees, but it's still not like it is on a summer's day. So our base rail is what you clip the polythene into, and once I've clipped that into there, I want to leave a bit of a gap, pull it as tight as I can for this time of year, and leave an inch or so that we can do it again in summer. That means I can't plant right up to the edge, which is not a bad thing, because if you ever come to replacing the polythene, you can unbolt things. So I'll just show you what I mean by that. So this is the base rail, and the polythene clips into the back of it, and you basically can slide this up and down, so the polythene will clip into the back there. You undo these bolts so you can move it up and down. So I'm leaving a gap, so that line there is where we would call the ground level, where the saw's going to be up to. Then it says come 7 centimetres up. I'm going to actually go a bit further up than that, because our polythene is not going to be as malleable. So I shall pull it down, and then I shall go a bit further. This is the thing, these are in the way. It's all right for them saying in the instructions, screw this in there and then slide that down, but actually that gets in the way on that last bit. I probably will be able to get it possibly down to there, and some of them slightly higher with the screws. I didn't realise it was such a problem, because the instructions don't tell you what to do or where to screw it. It might have been better somewhere around there, but even still, it's an awkward place, because this has got to slide up and down all the way around. There's a little gap just around there where you possibly miss it, but it's risky, might still hit. So you keep coming across these problems. You know, it's got to be screwed. It's got to be screwed there to the anchor plate. So that's a bit of an annoying thing. You know, the other thing is, if I just go as low as I can, I might end up moving the screws a bit lower down on some of them, and then just go as far as that and use that as my point of where it stops. There's a metal bar that goes inside these here, and there's like little screws that are that one I couldn't get all the way in. They're rusty to begin with, which is quite frustrating. So they're Allen key little screws that hold those bits of metal in. That's fresh out the packet, a bit rusty. Somewhat frustrating, really. And it's those bits of metal that go inside the rails to put them, fix them together. So, did our timbers yesterday. They're use them nail plates on there. Today's just trying to get the rail levelled up. So I'm going to come sort of 9 centimetres above ground level. And it'll be a case of tightening it a bit this year, get it as tight as I can. Then either see in summer if it'll tighten up or the following year, tighten it up a bit more. So I'll just have to let the polythene trowel down over the side a little bit. And put some weights on it, some timbers on it on the bottom just to stop it moving. Although it's really muddy, it's exciting. It's quite a big space actually. It's quite a nice big airy space, and I like the fact that it's not a very long tunnel. It's only 30 foot long, but it's 20 foot wide. And with the big double doors, big sliding double doors that are going to be on it, it's going to let a lot of air in, which is a good thing. So these little bars that go between the rails to hold them together, they've got this like little screw, that hex screw, and what was it, like an Allen key type thing. And when you put them inside the rail, the base rail, and try to screw these, I get more than halfway through some of them, and then it just jams in there and won't tighten. And I've probably had 4 or 5 of them that have done that now, that just will not tighten. One of them's got 2 on just one bar. And as clean as I know, it's muddy out here, and as clean as I keep them, some of these are quite rusty already. That's an annoyance. That's one thing I'm finding annoying, is this isn't a good idea. This is fine, but have a stainless steel screw, that thing that's covered in black paint that's rusting,
is just rubbish, because when it comes, if you ever want to remove it, that's going to be rusted in there. And you're going to have to drill it out or something. I'd have preferred a nut and bolt sort of job. I don't know what you'd call it, I'm not sure. I've never used anything like that before. Never want to again. So before I start trying to put polythene on, I've got to try and sort out this muddy situation. So I'm just laying this membrane over mud. It's horrendous, but I'm making the best of a bad situation. And I'm gonna put wood chip over that, and I'm gonna go around the sides. And if I've got membrane left, I'll put some around the sides. I only ordered so much of this stuff, and I can't remember, so long ago I ordered it. Can't remember how much I actually ordered, whether it was enough to just do paths in there or to do the whole lot, so I'm gonna see how far it goes. And I've just got to do something about the mud, because the last thing I want to do is start rolling polythene out to go over the top, and it's all muddy, covered in mud, everything's just covered in mud. This is a summertime job. It really is. I'm going a little bit further over on the edges so I don't miss any, have any gaps when I come to put in the polythene. I don't want a bit where weeds will get growing. And I've done down the back edge here, so I've cut a bit off and laid another bit. Just enough. I don't want anything growing up against the polytunnel. I don't want weeds wearing the polythene out. So that'll just be wood chipped, otherwise the UV light will make that all break up eventually. Then if I can do the same on that side, it gives me an area to lay the polythene out. That side's much better, much drier as well. The middle of here is like a quagmire over there. Hoping once I start getting a little bit of wood chip, it'll just level it out, like distribute the weight, so I don't end up sinking in there. Thank you. So we've got the polythene on now, and we've done the doors, and it needs tightening up still a bit. There's some crinkles in it that have appeared when it gets a bit warmer. But I'm going to wait till it gets really warm before I start pulling them out with the using the base rails. I'm quite happy with it for now. It does feel quite tight in places, except where these crinkles are, but they will pull out. I think it just needs to warm up a bit. It's not bad. There were certain things that frustrated me with this first tunnel's polytunnel, the base rails at the ends, not having an extra piece of timber further up, because other ones I'd seen, earlier ones of first tunnels, had timber further up. I've seen a few people talk about their polytunnels and they've got timber further up, and that would be good for our sliding doors, having battens off of that to stop it hitting the polythene, and having it low down, you could do with another one further up really. So the Q clips and the P clips, they were a pain. They weren't really, some of them weren't actually sort of the right shape, I'd say. Very difficult to put up, not a flat thing. The bolts weren't really long enough to get hold of it, and then you had to almost whack them into shape to tighten them up. It all took so much longer than I thought it was going to take, and it didn't need to really. I've built lots of things. I've never put a polytunnel up, but I just think these are, it was just a little bit more thought. The inserts in the base rail as well, I say a third of those hadn't been screwed out right. I couldn't put a screw in them. There were some contradictory things in the manual. There was a bit about putting the nail plates on the doors. It said turn over repeat, which was what we would do with using nail plates, go either side. And then it says when you put the polythene on, the side that hasn't got the nail plates, put the polythene on. You're just like, well, there was some contradictions there. I'm not blown away with it, but it's a good space, and it'll do me. And I'll hopefully, 5 or 6 years time, I'll try and be able to make things better, make the polythene maybe look a bit tidier, try and get all my pleats further up. When I was doing it before, they were looking like jumbo jet wings, because there seemed to be so much of it. Have extra bits of timber in would help. So there are lessons to be learned, and it's for growing vegetables. They're not going to care what it looks like. So if you found this video interesting, consider liking and subscribing, and hopefully we'll see you again soon.